Okay, yeah, guys, welcome to last day session. Today we are going to discuss about yet another statistical test, ANOVA, analysis of variance. They used to call it as analysis of variance. When we supposed to use ANOVA? That would be our question. Anytime if we are trying to compare more than two groups, for example, MSW five sections. Imagine you have five sections, A section through E section. Then I want to compare your academics, who is doing better, how, when is all the five sections are same, significantly there is a difference among sections. So in order to understand that significance, whether these five sections are having different characteristics of learning or they are all of same. So in this context, we can use ANOVA, analysis of variance. Here also, you will be doing five-step process, which we have discussed for t-test also. We need to decide confidence level. We need to decide the critical value. Then we need to calculate f-test. So instead of t-test, here we will be calculating f-test. Using f-test, we need to conclude. So these are all the steps involved. Let us see one by one. Very first step, we need to understand how to calculate sample size, sample mean, sample standard deviation. N1, N2. Sample mean we all know, but this notational convention I wanted to introduce, nothing more. N1 is a sample size of the group 1. Let it be A section, MSW A section. Let us consider this belongs to MSW A section. Then group 2. Number of students in that section, I mean to say N2, MSW B section. So not necessarily to be equal number of students, maybe with dropped or maybe few sections there is no appropriate admission, few section full of admission, something will be there. We no need to worry. The number of students we need to count. Then C section, MSW students, N3, excuse me, D section, N4, that's it. Next, sample mean we need to calculate. What is mean? Simple. We need to do sum of all A section students' marks. Then I need to divide by N. That particular class, how many students are there? That N I need to use and divide. That result would become average or mean. Here we are going to write it as sample mean as x1 bar for the first sample. Similarly, we are trying to write x2 bar for the second sample, x3 bar for the third section, fourth section, x4 bar. That's it. Then standard deviation, because this notational convention only, you will feel confused when you look at formula. It is not so, afraid, no need to afraid of mathematical equations. If we know the appropriate interpretation, each and every component of the formula, if we know, then it is straightforward plug-in and finding out. At the max, you will be doing subtraction, multiplication, squaring, square root, these division. These are all the four operations you'll be doing. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are our childhood mathematics. Then we may trying to do squaring. Then we may trying to do square root. That's it. So these all four, already it is been introduced in Excel. So now we are going towards the next discussion. 1 minute. Another notation, standard deviation. For the first group, standard deviation is S1. Second group, standard deviation is S2. Third group, S3. Fourth group, S4. That's it. So you need to understand these all elements. Once if you are thorough on these elements, we need to formulate the hypothesis. What hypothesis says? As already I mentioned in the previous class, H naught and H A, HO and HA, they used to say H naught, HA. Null hypothesis, this is said to be null hypothesis. This is said to be alternate hypothesis. Now, when to use null, when to use alternate hypothesis? This we need to formulate very clearly. So that is where every research or project will become successful. For example, null hypothesis always discourage. I said you need to remember that word discourage. Alternate hypothesis always will encourage. You need to remember that word encourage. Now what will happen here for the null hypothesis? Section A to section E. That is what my comparative study. So there is no difference. It will discourage. There is no difference, it will say, it will try to say. Whereas alternate hypothesis, what will do is there is a difference. Completely you need to write difference in academic performance. What I wanted to compare, I said initially, your academic performance. There is a difference in your academic performance. Whereas for null hypothesis, what we supposed to write? There is no difference in your academic performance. That's all. I need to write like this. Please try to understand. Null hypothesis, never it will encourage. Alternate hypothesis, it will encourage. So it will say something. It will give something to take action, to think differently. If there is no difference, why I should sit and analyze? So that is the reason we used to say statisticians, null hypothesis will discourage, alternate hypothesis should encourage. If there is a difference only, I can think of some awards, some appreciation, or special coaching for the weak performer or weak section, something like that. Or I can substitute the best teacher to the poor section or weak section. These are all possibilities will come together. If there is no difference, why I should bother? So all the sections performing equally, then there is no use of analyzing. That is the meaning I am trying to say. It is encouraging, it is discouraging, no other meaning. Now, after this point of understanding, let us try to understand. See, look at what ANOVA tries to do is mean value, comparing mean value of each and every group. So look at H naught, all the means are same. Next, H1, means of not are all equal, not at all equal. So that is the meaning. Finally, statistics which is used for ANOVA is this formula. You may feel like fainting, don't worry. It will be much easier. With one example we are going to discuss. So even if you are looking at the formula, look at here, summation, N, number of samples we discussed, no? N1, section A, N2, N3, N4. Four group I discussed. So that number of samples. Sorry. Next, xj bar minus x bar. So we need to find out the residual, the differences or the variance or variation. So that variation square divided by K minus 1. What is that K minus 1? We need to look at shortly. Next, similarly, X minus XJ bar, the whole square, N minus K. All the parameters are known to us. Nothing to worry about. What is all about? Look at here, only K component we need to further discuss. K represents the number of independent groups. How many sections I said? Five sections, but in that example, if you look at only four groups, but for the story purpose, I said five sections. Then if at all I'm telling five section students I want to compare, then what is your k? Your k is 5. Imagine in your institution, there are 5 different sections of MSW first year available. Then all the 5 sections together, I need to consider. So all the 5 sections I need to consider. Yeah, started. I don't know who is doing this one. So K, perhaps you would have understood right now what is all about. Number of independent groups which we consider. Then what is capital N? This capital N is available here. All the N's, number of students in the section 1 or A section, number of students in the section 2 or B section, number of students in the section 3, etc. So these all N1 through N3 can be named it as capital N. Hope so you would be understanding each and every component of the formula. Rest all, naturally you can able to understand. Now, degrees of freedom 1, degrees of freedom 2. You try to understand these as well. So what is the meaning of DF1, degrees of freedom 1? For the ANOVA analysis, we need to calculate 2 different degrees of freedom, DF1, DF2. DF1 is K minus 1. In your institution, there are 5 different sections for first year MSW, then DF1 is going to become K minus 1. So 5 minus 1, 4. Next, DF2, it would become total number of students minus 5 sections. Each section, let us take for example, 100 students. So 5 sections, 500 students minus K, how many sections? 5. Then 495 is going to become your DF2, degrees of freedom 2. So these are all few stuff you should able to interpret, you should be able to know before proceeding with the problem solving. Next, what you supposed to do? See, degrees of freedom equal to 3, degrees of freedom equal to 36, K is equal to 4, N is equal to 40. Then alpha value is 0.05. What is alpha value? Confidence interval, 95% confidence interval. If your F value is less than, you need to take one decision. If your F value is greater than, you need to take one decision. That's it. So these are all the preliminary understanding you should have before stepping into solving a problem. So now, between treatments, error, N minus K, K minus 1, N minus 1, you need to calculate this table. That's it. If you know this table, you are done with MSW. You can done with ANOVA. You can do in Excel or the calculator which I introduced, you can do. Finally, F value MSB divided by MSE. What is MSB? Look at here. SSB divided by K minus 1. What is MSE? MSE divided by N minus K. Now, reverse. Try to work in the reverse. What is SSB? See, here it is given. SSB. This is what? Summation of NJ, open bracket, XJ bar minus X bar the whole square. What is SSC? This is not MSC, SSC. Maybe printing mistake. So you need to substitute this value. What is SST? You need to calculate X minus X bar. So this is the simple table you need to interpret or you need to understand. From in which let us solve one problem, you can be able to understand through that problem. Nothing to worry. Look at here, there is a control group. What is the control group is? In medical field, they used to have one control group, one experimental group. So for that control group and experimental group, they will be comparing. Before giving the medicine, what is the effect? After giving the medicine, what is the effect? There is another group. For them, they will be observing without medicine. So without injecting that medicine, they will be observing, or they may give some other medicine. Then they will be comparing these two groups, how the progress of health increased. So that is what, in general, the medical application they used to go about. Look at here, you can even read aloud. Please focus your attention, read this problem statement. Even I am going to read the problem statement, nothing more. A clinical trial is run to compare weight loss programs, clinical trial, weight loss therapy, and participants are randomly assigned to one of the comparison programs. They are picking role number one, they are giving to one kind of treatment. They are picking role number two, they are given to another kind of treatment. They are picking role number three, they are giving to another kind of treatment, something like that. So different ways to reduce weight, we all know. We can go for fasting, or we can go for balanced diet, or we can go for exercise, or we can go for yoga. Anything is possible. There are plenty of ways available to reduce the weight. So we are subjecting each and every person to different way of weight reduction therapy. Next, assigned to one of the comparison programs and are counseled on the details of the assigned program. Participants follow the assigned program for 8 weeks. 8 weeks they are going to follow. The outcome of the interest is weight loss. Finally, what is their interest is it should happen weight loss. So which is doing better? Is there any significant difference among different therapeutic method, or there is no difference among different therapeutic methods? So that is what they want to study. Defined as the difference in weight measured at the start of the study baseline. Beginning, they will be measuring their weight. After 8 weeks, they'll be measuring their weight. Then they can easily understand the differences. Normally, we do the same, no? We do dieting for 10 weeks, or we do dieting for one month. Then we do go for weight comparison. Weight is measured in the scale or unit pounds. Three popular weight loss programs are considered. What are all the method? One is low calorie food. Another one is low fat food. Another one is low carbohydrate food. So which one leads to the best way of weight reduction is of their interest. The control group is included here to assess the placebo effect. Weight loss due to simply participating in the study. That is what a classical research in medical field. I will tell you what is the placebo effect. Medical field, imagine 10 members of some family or someone having headache. They will be picking 5 patients for giving the real-time medicine, original medicine. The other 5 headache patients will be given pseudo medicine. What is pseudo medicine is placebo effect. They will give you a tablet, but inside it will not be original medicine. It will be something eatable powders, something like that. It's a kind of, or only empty capsule. They will make you to think, or your brain need to think, your belief system need to be empowered that you are given a medicine by the doctor, you will be getting cured. So that is called placebo effect. Simply participating in the study. They will not follow the diet. A total of 20 patients agreed to participate in the study. 20 patients and are randomly assigned to one of the 4 diet groups. So each and every patient is given to here, one method. Weights are measured at baseline and patients are counseled on the proper implementation of the assigned diet with the exception of the control group. So after 8 weeks, you are measuring the weight of each patient. So the differences you are noting down. That difference, you need to understand what is this 1 minute. This plus and minus indicate weight gains. Look at here. Negative difference indicates weight gain. Positive differences indicate weight loss. So this person have got the increased weight of 1 kg. this person, there is no big difference. This is control group, understand? This is another group. They were into diet of eating low carbohydrate. This is another group. They are given the therapeutic method of low fat food eating. This group is given the therapeutic method of low calorie food eating. So if you look at all over, control group, they haven't participated, but we are observing without taking these all. In simple terms, what no? There are five fellow. They don't like any of the diet method. So they are living their own way. That's all. What they want, they are eating, they are living, enjoying. We want to analyze, what is there any significant difference is there, or there is no difference? What is null hypothesis? It will always discourage. There is no big difference among these four groups. That is the meaning it will tell. So what is minus one? 1 kg this fellow have gained after 8 weeks. This fellow, there is no increase in weight. Whereas these three fellows have reduced weight. That is the indication given in the problem statement. We need to first understand the problem statement. Sometimes directly they don't give what the test we need to use. Then the headache starts. Exactly, we need to analyze and think a lot what statistical test we need to use. If it is given, it would be happy. We no need to worry. Now fine, we understood so far now only the problem. Nothing else we are trying now. Look at here. First, H naught means are not, means are not all equal. H naught is what? There is all are equal. H1, here H1 starts. Means are not all equal. Not at all equal. You can write all means are not equal. You can write in any English sentence. It doesn't matter. H0 is what? All the therapeutic methods are same. That's it. So there is no big difference. Whereas H1 says, yes, there is a difference. Next, what is the confidence level you are choosing? 95% confidence level. If you choose 95% confidence level, the significance of difference would become 0.05. This is the meaning, significance of difference. How the significance of difference is obtained? This we have discussed in the earlier class. If the confidence interval CI is 95, then you need to choose this. You need to choose this. So the next step, we need to go for calculating F test. Then we need to apply the decision rule. Then we need to take the decision. How we are going to do step by step? Now, critical value we need to calculate, 3.24. This critical value we can take it from the chart. So using this critical value only, we are going to take decision. Our duty is to calculate only the F. If we calculate F, one critical value is fixed, 3.24, the critical value is fixed. So how you need to look at the critical value? You need to look at this degrees of freedoms. DF1 equal to K minus 1, DF2 equal to N minus K. DF1 is what? 4 minus 1 is equal to 3, 4 groups, DF2. N minus K, 20 minus 4, 4 groups, 16. Low calorie, low fat, low carbohydrate and control group all together. Through in which you are going to calculate. Using these all, it is possible to calculate the critical value, 3.24. Once if you have obtained the critical value from the chart, it is possible for us to take decision F greater than or equal to 3.24. If F becomes greater than the critical value, you need to reject. That means HA. What is HA? It says that there is a significant difference among each and every method of therapy. That is the meaning we are going to calculate. First step. What you supposed to do? First step, number N, all the groups, control group, all the groups are 555. 20 participants or 20 candidates are participating in the study. You need to just calculate mean. What is the mean? Look at here. You need to do summation of these all, divided by 5, because 5 members only available in this group. You need to do sum of these all divided by 5. You need to do sum of these all divided by 5. You need to do sum of these all divided by 5. Using that approach, they have calculated 6.6, 3, 3.4, 1.2. These are all the obtained mean, group mean they have taken. Now we need to calculate xj bar nj minus x bar. What is n? All the group number of participants are 5. That's fine. Next, you need to know how it is calculated. This 6.6 minus 3.6, how it is calculated is the question. Now let us go back quickly. Look at here. 8, 9, 6, 7, 3. You need to calculate 6.6 minus 3.6. This is the 6.6. This value you need to consider xj bar minus x bar. X bar is fixed. X bar is 3.6. So you need to subtract x bar. See, the overall mean is x bar. Here it is calculated, it is available. N is equal to 20. Overall mean. What is the overall mean? Let us see. You need to do sum of this, 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 this. All the 20 elements, you need to do summation. Divided by 20. Number of elements are 20. This is not 20. Look at here. You need to do 8 plus 9 plus 6 plus 7 plus 3 plus 2 plus etc. Each and every element you need to add. Continue adding. These all together you need to calculate divided by 20. That is the meaning given here. So that overall mean is 3.6. So how each and every mean is deviating from the overall mean? That is what we are trying to find out. See, look at xj, 6.6. What is overall mean? 3.6. xj, 3.0. What is n? Every sample 5 only. Minus x bar, 3.6. 3.4 minus 3.6, 1.2 minus 3.6, then whole square of every term. Then you will be having these steps. This result you need to remember, it will be helpful for further. So don't worry, there are several packages available, SPSS, then the calculator which I introduced to you, much more helpful. Now, look at here. This 75.5, let it be. You keep it aside. Next step, what do you need to calculate? The table which is available, you are listing out. What is the mean? Every group mean deviation we are calculating. First, we are calculating overall mean deviation. Now, we are trying to calculate every group mean deviation. So, 6.6 is the mean value. So 2 minus 6.6, well, this difference you will be calculating. So every time you need to calculate this one, 6.6, 8 minus 6.6, 1.4, 9 minus 6.6, 2.4, 6 minus 6.6, minus 0.6. You need to do square of everything. That square value is 21.4. Now you have obtained 21.4. This is called deviation. So within that group, mean deviation. Similarly, second group. So you need to write down these all value. What is the mean associated with that? 3. Do the difference. 2 minus 3, 1. 4 minus 3, 1. 3 minus 3, 0. 5 minus 3, and so on. Then square. Do the sum. So sum is available here. Similarly, for the third group, fourth group, control group, all the group, once you are done, SSC, you need to calculate. Whatever you have attained, that you need to do sum. So 47.4. So all the major calculations we are done. Now we need to move towards that final table. We started with this table. Now we are going to end with that table. So how this table is available? Look at here. Between treatment 75.8. Where that 75.8? Look at here. Overall mean deviation we calculated very first. This 75.8. So you are keeping here. Next, error 47.4. How did you calculate this error? Every group the mean deviation you just know, every table we have calculated. That is 47.4. Now you need to add these two. That is 123.2. Degrees of freedom. First degrees of freedom, 4 minus 1, 3. 20 minus 4, 16. These are all called n minus k, k minus 1. This is k minus 1 formula. This is n minus k formula. This is what I shown there. Next is n minus 1 formula. What is k? Number of group. In this treatment method, how many groups? 4 groups. Number of people, how many are participated? 20. Just to use the formula. Nothing more is difficult. See, I'll write down here. This is k minus 1. Number of groups are 4. 4 independent groups. No way related. These guys are 8 weeks. They are eating only low fat food. These guys are eating only low calorie food. These guys are eating only low carbohydrate food. Next is n minus k. Next is n minus 1. Next, what you need to do? You need to find out F value. How you are finding out F value? 75.8 divided by 3 is equal to 25.3. SSC, SSB, that is what the formula I have shown. So these all available here. Every column is dependent on each other. 75.8 divided by 3. 47.4 divided by 16, the corresponding row only. See, this divided by this, this divided by this, that's all. Then you will be doing this divided by this. Finally, you are obtaining 8.43. This is how statistics will be working. Now 8.43. Hope so you would be remembering the critical value noted down is almost 3.2. This much only I remember. Critical value 3.2. We need to compare the obtained value 8.43 to 3.2 in order to take decision. Now no more calculation. Only decision making we should do. How we are doing the decision making? Look at here. 8.43 is greater than 3.4. 3.4 is critical value. If it is greater, we need to reject H naught. We need to accept HA. We need to accept. Finally, if you are accepting, what is the meaning? There is a difference in mean weight loss among 4 diets. Yes, there is a lot of difference. Then how to interpret which has best method? That all goes on. That's it. So with that introduction, this itself almost we have spent 45 minutes. Look at here. Next problem. Normal bone density, osteopenia, osteoporosis, some disease or something, method of treatment. That's all. So you need to look at and work on, read the problem statement, understand this, calculate step by step, the same steps. But if you rehearse, if you work on this, you are understood anova thoroughly. Next, so far now what we have discussed is called one way anova. Now we are going for two factor anova. I don't teach, I will just introduce and stop. This particular link has all the fantastic articulation and explanation. You can keep watching or you can keep learning by yourself. Because I need to move on to the next topic of discussion, chi-square test. After that, PowerPoint. Very quickly, I will rush up with the PowerPoint. With that, let us conclude. See, look at here. What is the meaning is, I want to analyze gender wise, for example, your mark, your performance, A section, how boy students are performing, girl students are performing. Look at how many levels I'm bringing. This is called two factor ANOVA, two way ANOVA. Next, B section, I want to analyze your academic performance gender wise. How boys are performing, how girls are performing. C section, I want to analyze boys and girls. Every class, two more level I am bringing. Every class, two more level I am bringing. Every class, two more level I am bringing. That's it. So for this, the way of doing would become little bit different. So we need to calculate differently. So that's it. Male, female, we need to calculate, we need to go ahead. The necessary foundation is given to you. I will just copy paste this link in the chat window. Kindly note down. So this exercise, if you do, you can understand. Now let us go to the calculator. See, this is what before even your arrival I did. Look at here. I have categorized poor performer, excellent performer, academics, two group. Female, male, simply, randomly I introduced the mark. So what it is giving, finally, p-value, obtained p-value, see, look at chi-square, this is chi-square statistics, not ANOVA. So I need to introduce first chi-square, let it be. Now hypothesis testing, we are done. So within this also you can do ANOVA. Look at here. You copy paste that data, look at here. ANOVA calculator, independent measure, one way ANOVA calculator for independent measure. You use this link, I click you. The problem which we solved, na, copy paste that. We are having only four group, that all the values copy paste, copy paste, copy paste. Just click this, calculate, we are done. No more job. How easy, you just imagine. The same result we will get. So no need to worry. So that SPSS I haven't introduced, so that I am introducing this calculator. What I supposed to do? Look at in the problem statement, low calorie. In that column, whatever is there, type it here or copy paste. Then low carbohydrate, whatever is there, low fat, control group. There are four columns available in the original data, the problem statement. That all four columns you need to copy paste into this cells. After that, that problem which is solved on the internet uses 95% confidence interval, 0.05 significant alpha level, alpha value, alpha level. So you need to click calculate. In one button click, it will give. But you should know what is happening. Exam point of view, they don't give you calculator. They will ask you to write something. So what is ANOVA? Types of ANOVA, analysis of variance, what are all the steps involved, what is the formula. At least you should know these all. Examination point of view, by having the formula is also essential. At least you can understand. If the formula components are understood, the concept is thorough enough, no more by having. Now 1 minute if I look at, enough for me. I can remember even after 1 week also I can say the formula. That's all about ANOVA. Let us move on to chi-square analysis. From there, we will move on to PowerPoint. This is about my PhD thesis. What first I need to introduce to you one thing, 1 minute. Very first step, when you can use chi-square, that you should understand. So far now you would have noticed keenly, I started, if the population mean is given, number of samples are more than 30, you are supposed to use z-test. If the number of samples are less than 30, you are supposed to use t-test. The formula, everything will become same. Only z value, the table value, and t value, the critical value, reference only will vary from z-test to t-test. Then we moved on to Pearson correlation. That is no way connected to anything. That is the simplest method of doing statistics. Then we moved on to today, ANOVA. In the ANOVA, you would have noticed F-test. What is indirectly we are using in ANOVA is F-test. So using this ANOVA, it is possible to calculate mean value. Whenever in your problem statement, numerical values are involved, that time you need to use either t-test, z-test or f-test depending upon the problem statement and the availability of the data. Please understand, whenever your data has categorical variable, what is categorical variable? Pass, fail, A grade, B grade, female, male, married, unmarried, alcoholic, non-alcoholic, smoker, non-smoker. These are all the kind of data is termed as categorical data. When your data set and the problem statements are highly related to categorical data, how you can solve the problem is a point of discussion now. This one method will stand out among all other methods. That is the reason I was postponing chi-square till the end of the day. All other tests so far now we discussed, right from we started with mean, mode, median, standard deviation, t-test, z-test, ANOVA. All those stuff will be aptly suitable for numerical variable or continuous variable. What is numerical or continuous? If the available data are in the form of number. Understand like a kid. If the given data are looks like a number, that number could be whole number or floating point number. What is whole number? 5. Let me say, for example, 5. This is whole number. The moment I say 5.5, this is float number. But however, both are continuous data type. Continuous data type. Or it is called numeric data type. For this kind of data only, we discussed mean, we discussed median, we discussed mode, we discussed t-test, we discussed z-test, even we discussed standard deviation. Next. Today we discussed ANOVA, analysis of variance. Underneath we used called F-test. The moment your data is of continuous in nature, data type, then you are permitted to use these all tests. Then depending upon your problem statement and the available data, based on these two only you can choose any of the test. Otherwise it is not possible. This is where struggle, available data and the data type, problem statement, all the three together only will guide, and the expertise of the statistics. Given the data, problem statement is given, but there is no clue about what test to be used, then we will be struggling. We need to be pretty much confident enough what test we need to use. For that, depth of this all model is important. Thorough understanding of the data type is important. pretty much a thorough understanding of the problem statement or the domain is important. Only then the person can be a perfect statistician or perfect research, carried out a perfect research. These are all one category. Please make a note, or I will save and finally I will send the material. Now, we let us look at into second category. What is that category? That category is called categorical data. If it is involved like female, male, smoker, non-smoker, fail, pass. These kind of information, if you could see in the data set, these all are termed as categorical data. For the analysis of categorical data only, the test, it is called chi-square test. It is introduced. Chi-square test, when you need to use, any moment you are working on only on the categorical data, you are permitted to use chi-square test. Understand, guys? If you have any question, any moment you can use a chat window, no need to hold. Now, hope so you would be understanding into what context, what test you need to use. So now this is the introduction I am trying to give for categorical data. Now, what is a chi-square test does? Very first step, you need to do cross-tabulation. What is cross-tabulation? You need to calculate the table. The table finally gives, for example, I am having female, male, poor students. I will be labeling every student as a poor or excellent. Your class information I am having. Let us consider here. I am having roll number 1. Roll number 1 is female. I am labeling roll number 1 as a excellent. There is a roll number 2, male. I am labeling as a poor. There is a roll number 3, male. I am labeling as a category excellent. There is a roll number 4. Like this, your data would look. Shortly, I will write 4, female. I am labeling as poor. 5, male, poor. 6, male, excellent. 7, female, poor. 8, female, poor. 9, female, excellent. This is the data available. First column is not a significant. It is a kind of identification. Row number or roll number, anything you keep it as, according to your choice. If you look at second column, it is a gender column. If you look at third column, it is a grade column. I am grading you all. In this situation, you need to calculate cross-tabulation. How to calculate cross-tabulation? Let us see. I need to come out with a table. How I can come out? Poor. I am going to call it as excellent. These all are rows. Column I am going to call it as male and female. I need to calculate the count I need to fill out. Now I can use pen. Look at here. Poor male combination, how many are there? One poor male combination. See, one poor male combination. Another poor male combination. So how many poor male combination available in the 9 data set? Only 2. I need to write down here 2. Next, poor female. Poor female 1. Poor female 2. Poor female 3. So I need to fill here 3. Next, excellent male 1. Excellent male. Excellent male 2. I need to fill here 2. Excellent female 1. Next, excellent female 1, 2. This is called cross tabulation. I need to calculate the frequency count. This is called another word, otherwise technically people call it as contingency table. Contingency table. This is called as contingency table. You need to calculate the frequency count of this pair. You need to calculate the frequency count of this pair. You need to count the frequency count of this combination. You need to count the frequency count of this combination. That's all. This is a very primary step required for chi-square test. This is called cross tabulation. Next, let us move on and discuss the rest. Look at here, always null hypothesis will be discouraging. Brain, this is my PhD research. What is this is? Brain dominance analysis. Using psychometric, every person brain dominance. What is the meaning is? The power of thinking. How each and every student have the power of thinking that. And learning style. What is their learning style they are adapting? So I want to find out, is there any dependency? There is no dependency. I have set on H naught. I have set on HA. There is a dependency. The learning style and thinking power has relationship or dependency. No relationship, dependency I mean to say. Whereas here I am telling this. So this is what the claim carried out. Then the contingency table is formulated. That contingency table, I have used some packages. Using the packages, finally, I'm getting two-sided two-tail. What is this two-tail? This two-tail. One tail is greater than or less than, I need to use one tail. Equal to or not equal to, I need to use. Because brain dominance learning style, I can't use greater than or less than. I need to use equal to only, either equal to or not equal to. So that is the reason two-sided. So degrees of freedom, 9. So finally, the obtained value is this. This value, I need to compare and take decision. If at all manual calculation, it would go another half an hour like ANOVA. The same like ANOVA, you can calculate this also. Look at here, P obtained P value is 0.02. This is what I have obtained. The set a significance level or confidence interval is, alpha level is 0.05. This is less than this. When it is less than this, H naught is rejected, HA is accepted. Whenever it goes greater only, H0 is accepted. What is the meaning? It is evident that types of learning style and types of brain dominance are dependent. The person type of learning, the person type of thinking power has dependency to each other. That is a claim I have obtained. My thesis goes 260 page. One piece of information I am trying to show. Now, let us walk through one more table also. See, next, brain dominance, multiple intelligence. Your thinking power and your intelligence, I wanted to say, are independent, no way related. I am trying to say dependent. Forget about this prime and all. So now look at, this is what the obtained p-value. This is greater than 0.05. So H naught is accepted. So I wanted to show for both of the case. Conclusion, hypothesis setting only very difficult. This is possible because nowadays plenty of calculators are available. That will guide us. Now p-value is obtained this, which is greater than the 0.05. Hence H naught is accepted, HA is rejected. In which, what is the meaning is, it is statistically evident that multiple intelligence or prime intelligence obtained from the theory of MI and types of brain dominance are independent. There is no relationship between your power of thinking and your intelligence. So the internally it is different, don't worry. So this is the claim I made. Look at here, prime 2 intelligence, second. Next 0.31, which is less than, look at here, 0.05, 0.031. Then naturally I'll be rejecting H naught, accepting HA. Now what is the meaning? Prime 2 intelligence and the brain dominance both are dependent to each other. That is the meaning. Prime 1 intelligence only not dependent. It is independent of each other. Prime 2 intelligence is dependent of each other. That is the claim I made. Arjun, 1 minute. So this is the claim. Hope so you would be able to get it. Now let us go towards that online calculator. This also I had given you yesterday. If you wish, once again today also I can share the link. Make a note of it. This is the link. Sorry, chi-square this, ANOVA that. Anyway, one link is sufficient. All the tests are available here. Look at here. Just for fun, for academic point of view learning, I have entered this. How I have entered, I will show you once again. Female contingency table. This is called contingency table. 45, 78, 67, 21. From this, it starts calculating marginal column total, marginal column total, marginal row total, grand total, within which it starts finding out other statistical inferences. These all possible to tell only step by step. Finally, see, obtained p-value is this 0.001, which is less than, p is less than 0.5. Then you need to take decision what if it is less than HA. HA is what? What is your claim you can make? H naught, you can say there is no difference between female student and male student in the academic performance. What is HA? There is a dependency. Gender and academic performance are dependent. Here I can make a claim. Gender and academic performance, there is no dependency. Gender and academic performance have got a dependency. That is a claim I'm making. So now let us go back. Back to calculators. Let us go to calculators. Look at here. Contingency table 2x2. If you are working for only two variable, that is male, female, poor, excellent. If you have multiple category, when multiple category will come, look at, I'm grading you all guys into 4 group, excellent group, average group, very good and poor, or good and poor. By the time 4, how many genders in your class, assuming that only 2 gender, female and male, if at all any one of your classmates happen to become other gender, then 3 category, then it would become 4x3. If other gender is also studying, if only 2 genders are studying, 4x2, that's all. So you need to choose any one of this table depending upon your requirement. See, chi-square calculator, for goodness of it, several test calculators are available. You can use any one of the method. So now look at here, take me to the calculator. I need to click. See, now it is setting. I need to, first step, I need to tell the category, female, male. I need to give the contingency table. Poor, academically poor, academically excellent. Next step. After the next step, I need to fill. See, already what I gave is available. 45, 67, 78. Randomly I had given. No relation. Next. I need to choose the significant level. Next, calculate chi-square. Yes. The obtained p-value is 0.00001. It is pretty much lesser than this. So that the conclusion is, there is a dependence between academic performance and the gender. That's all. It won't say which gender is doing good. Yes, it is possible. You need to look it into these all the details. The micro level details you need to look at, you can take decision. It would take a lot of time to step into that. PowerPoint, let us go quickly. Undo. Very few tricks I wanted to tell you. There are plenty of slides, templates are available. You need to download from the slide template internet. If you want me to show different templates, it will create wow factor. I will show my PPTs. I am pretty much good at creating PPT. One minute, I need to open it and only then it is possible. Look at here. These all a kind of creativity. It is a kind of passion. You should have a passion, patience and a passion. So look at here. So this is what the slide. This templates suitable for the computer science and engineering. So I have created this background template. I have downloaded. So how we need to create this? I have created using cool text. Then this is infographic. Then this is what, how it is showing. So your PPT should go to this level. See, these all are available in the downloaded template itself. So I have taken and I have customized. Look at here. These all available in the template itself. So like this, you can try one more method. Now, which one you want me to address, you tell me. Accordingly, I will address. Otherwise, it will take a lot of time for me to talk about PPT. Which one you are expecting me to explain, you need to address. I will just show a couple of my PPT. Look at here. This I have created using cool text. Entrepreneurship development I have addressed one day. See, future trend and futuristic strategies for the entrepreneurship skill. Look at here. So this is this, like this you can have control. When you press the button only, it will come. Look at here. So what level you are expecting, I don't know. If you say only, I can explain. This is one PPT. I'll show you one more PPT. And this animation trick I will show you. Look at here. These are all called GIF file. Could you able to notice car is moving, cloud is moving, GIF file. Any GIF file, you bring it to PPT, higher version, Windows 10.0, it will work for you. Look at here. Whenever you are pressing, it will come. Accordingly, you can tell. Look at here, this animation. So this all GIF file. The moment you bring GIF, you need to have GIF file from the internet. So then it is possible to create like this. This all, it is under your control. When you press only one by one, when I am addressing in the session, I'll bring on those topics. It will be under my control. This is also a GIF file. So it creates animation. Look at here. One more I'll show. There are several wow factors are available. If you look at it, this also GIF file animation. This doesn't have, this is a video. Look at here, this video is played. It is playing, it is not a GIF file, it is a video. You look at here how it is transmitting the control. If you look at this, lot of it is also GIF file, GIF. So it is creating lot of animation. So choice is, if you look at here, this also GIF file. Look at here, animation. So this is a technical concept. I used to try attempting to explain to some stuff of animation. This is one video. This is GIF file. Next is one more video will come. That's it. It go on. So you need to tell me what to be done. Only then I'll have clarity. Unless otherwise you tell in the chat window, I don't do anything. Otherwise I'll wind up today. No more stuff to tell. Guys, you need to be active, otherwise I will stop at this point because it is exceeded. I accepted for 1 hour. It is exceeded. Ma'am, are you there, ma'am? Satibama, ma'am? Ma'am is there? 1 minute. I'll allow to unmute. Satibama, ma'am, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
there
ma'am.
Nobody is active participating. I hope so. They know Excel. That is a sign I'm getting. Nothing more. The complete statistics, I have taken responsibility. You said that they are first year, they will be feeling difficult with statistics. So I started